I was almost done upgrading to Windows 10 when this screen popped up asking me to agree to a bunch of new settings. I admit, I wussed out and just hit the Express Settings button and let Windows take care of it, but then I discovered later that a lot of these settings affected my privacy. So now we're going to back up and go through customizing these settings so you can see what you're giving up. And remember, you can enable or disable any of these settings later in Windows 10. So here we are. I'm almost at the end of upgrading to Windows 10. And I'm going to hit the Next button. And here we go. It says, this is where you start to hit the Express settings. It says you can personalize your speech and typing and inking input. And this thing starts going on and on and on, and your eyes glaze over. So you could hit the Use Express settings down here on the right. But we're going to go through customizing instead. And that's the little link over here on the left. So here we go. And the first window of the settings is about personalization. Here's the first option. Microsoft wants to make sure that if it auto-corrects your input on your computer, that it's making sure that the restaurant is spelled correctly, or that your friend Melissa's name is spelled with one L and two S's instead of two L's and one S. And by getting your contact and calendar details, it can check all that information and get it right. So this sounds convenient, but this does mean that Microsoft is going to be getting all of your calendar and contact information and your input data. Microsoft says they're going to scramble that up so that they're not really watching what you're typing, but if that creeps you out, you can turn this off. Just remember that if you do this, you will be disabling Cortana. Here's the next one. Send typing and inking data to Microsoft to improve the recognition and suggestion platform. This is about Microsoft will actually record what you're typing and inking on your Windows 10 system. What they're trying to do is, the Windows Ink system is going to be able to recognize your scrawls and put them in your calendar and things like that. So they're basically using you as a guinea pig to improve their algorithms. They claim that they're going to anonymize all your data and they're not really going to be reading what you're doing. But if this creeps you out, you can turn that to off too. Oh, here's my favorite. Let apps use your advertising ID for experiences across apps. Did you know that you get an advertising ID when you upgrade to Windows 10? So awesome. You can't get rid of the advertising ID, unfortunately. But if you slide this to off, third parties will not be able to use your advertising info. Only Microsoft, which is some consolation. All right, here's the next one. Let Skype help you connect with friends in your address book and verify your mobile number, SMS, and data charges may apply. This is all about letting Skype get into your contacts so that they can load it automatically into Skype. If you use Skype a lot, this is really convenient. If you don't, you don't care and you can turn it off. Just realize that if you do keep this on, Skype will download all of your contacts, and if you want to take anyone else out, you're going to have to do that manually. All right, now let's go to location. This is similar to what you have on your phone. This will turn on Find My Device and let Windows and apps request your location, including location history, things like that. Microsoft may send it to trusted partners. We already all use location on our phone, and it's actually really important for apps like cab apps and restaurant apps and Yelp. So you probably want to keep this on, but if you're super duper private, all you have to do is slide it off right there. All right, now we'll hit the Next button. We have even more settings. This is about connectivity and error reporting. So you can automatically connect to suggested open hotspots. And Microsoft notes that not all networks are secure. So this is really about Wi-Fi security. You're going through a restaurant or a cafe and they might have some free Wi-Fi and you're like, awesome, I'll use it. But everybody knows that these Wi-Fi networks are not necessarily secure. So if you do not want to connect to them automatically, just turn that off. Here's another one, and a lot of people are really upset about this one. This is automatically connect to networks shared by your contacts. So these are your friends, your colleagues who might have Wi-Fi networks that you'll run into when you visit them. This feature would let you automatically connect to those networks and possibly bypass their passwords. So you might understand why they might feel unhappy about that. And a lot of people are turning this off. Here's the next one. Automatically connect to hotspots temporarily to see if paid Wi-Fi services are available. This is another situation where it just wants to find the Wi-Fi networks for you. Again, not all these networks may be very secure. So if you're comfortable finding networks on your own, and if you really don't want your computers just to connect randomly to Wi-Fi networks on the fly, just turn that off. Here's the last one under Wi-Fi. Send full error and diagnostic information to Microsoft. This is if something goes wrong, you want Microsoft to know what happened. This could actually help Microsoft improve Windows. They may not actually help you directly. If you're just not into sending Microsoft your data, you can turn that off. All right, next screen. Browser protection and update. This is to use the Smart Screen online services to help protect against malicious content. This is a Microsoft service that actually keeps a list of bad websites, and so if you visit them, it'll warn you. This is actually a good idea, and I suggest that you keep that one on. Here's the next one. Use page prediction to improve reading, speed up browsing, and make your overall experience better in Windows browsers. So this is a feature where Microsoft's Edge browser will watch what you're doing online and try to figure out where you would go next and load that page early so that Edge will perform faster. This is technically better if you like things to be faster. On the other hand, you may not want Microsoft to be watching what you're doing. So again, up to you whether you want that on or off. I'm sliding it off. Oh, here's a big one. Get updates from and send updates to other PCs on the internet to speed up app and Windows update downloads. What's happening here is that say that you want to update an application or update Windows 10, you think that you're going off to some server in Seattle, but no. Microsoft wants to be able to look at another computer in your home or another computer at your neighbor's house that might already have this update and download it from there. So think about it. You know, your computer is looking on other people's computers, and other people's computers are potentially looking at your computer to grab this update. I'm sure it's very efficient, but it just feels a little creepy, and I am turning this one off. All right, next screen. Meet Cortana. I actually like Cortana. She's, you know, Windows 10's digital assistant. She's very helpful. But the reason she's so helpful is because she kind of looks at what's going on in your calendar and what you're doing online and makes suggestions based on your activities. And as Microsoft spells out here, to let Cortana do her best work, Microsoft collects and uses information, including your location, your contacts, your voice input, a lot of things. And so if you're not interested in using Cortana, you can go down here and click Not Now. Just to keep things moving, I'm going to say that I'm going to use Cortana because I actually do like Cortana, but you have to be comfortable with understanding